There are things that were not done as per contract, so we advise them to rectify, especially where there is need grass, where there is need plant trees, and where there is need to put some drainage system. We are sure the contractors are going to correct that, and we are so grateful for that.
Joseph Birungi, who is the chairperson of Works Committee, explained the reason as to why they had to do monitoring on this project.
Monitoring is an oversight role of district councillors. As you are aware, district councillors, they have an oversight role of passing budgets and plans. So these projects are among the projects that were approved by district council, and therefore as a committee of works, we are supposed to come and see what we approved and what has been going on being executed by technocrats.
We are privileged to have the councillors of Kamwenje district, the works committee, doing the monitoring for the projects we have done as Kamwenje district. Our role technically is to introduce or to inform our councillors to fully understand that what they had planned in their councils is what really we are bringing on ground.
Nashanga ngo buri project etireho provision y'abantu abino bure mambure gwabo.
I've toured the market. What impressed me is that every project there has some provision for people with disabilities. This will help us access services and do business within the market. I urge all contractors to keep people with disabilities in mind when handling projects.
The only thing which can lay as a beat is greening because of drought. But suddenly we are coming to the rainy season, so we shall finish out of that one.
In Buikwe, since 2019, residents from the villages of Modern Farm, Lower Nava, Upper Nava, Chiraz Zone, Naminya North Triangle, Nalwere, Buloba and Bujowali in Njeru Central and Wakisi divisions have been complaining about environmental pollution by factories in the area. Residents say that factory owners dump industrial waste in water streams from which water for domestic use is fetched. After several complaints, non-government organization Girls for Climate Action teamed up with and coordinated the affected villages to write a petition to the Speaker of Parliament. A copy of this petition was given to Njeru Municipal Council. In the petition, factories Prunk, Modern Distillers, Gold Star, Grain Milling Company and Blue Ribbon are accused of discharging hazardous industrial effluent in water. These streams empty into River Nile and Lake Victoria. The petition describes how people in these villages have suffered from pollution for years and now seek Parliament's intervention.
The proprietors of these factories, some of them do accept that they have been polluting our water sources, because we have even letters where they have been writing, committing themselves to do some changes where need be to put this right, but there have been empty promises.
Based on what we are doing right now, I'm hopeful that things will turn around and we will have a positive action taken, because if they fail to fall and fulfill the requirements, we are not going to stop here. We will continue up to Parliament.
We came up to see that we invite community to talk about it, share their experiences, their stories. And after this particular petition, we are directing it to the town clerk, but also we are going to direct to the Speaker of Parliament, because community says they have done a lot of things to make sure that this happens, but nothing has been happening.
In Kabera Maido, Deputy IGG Anne Twinomucha Muhairwe has warned civil servants over growing cases of corruption. During her impromptu visit to Kabera Maido, Muhairwe singled out the main hospital, the education department, the Works Department, District Service Commission, and the Human Resource Department.
There is corruption in the Works Department, and these are reports I've received from this area. Now, this is Kabera Maido. In your Works Department, regarding roads.
Muhairwe visited Kabera Maido Hospital and the Kalipa Ateringalin Road. She said both need improvement.
We have also identified areas of extortion, some staff create situations where patients are forced to fork out money and pay for services that ordinarily not be paid for.
These allegations have always been there. We have tried as a facility, as a hospital. We have brought the the persons, alleged perpetrators. We have asked them to come to make a defense of themselves. And every time it has come, it has not been easy to verify facts.
Muhairev asked the chief administrative officer, the engineer alleged to have mishandled the road's work, to report to her office in Kampala to explain themselves. Story compiled by Anthony Atwine, Emmanuel Balukusa, and Michael Nyinge for the news.